Hi everyone, this is Ken LaRue from the Shotgun Team, and here's today's tip of the day in our 30 Tips in 30 Days. This tip is based on getting information and notification to your inbox based on the elements or entities you are following inside of your project. This way, you're getting the proper information and updates you need to get your job done. You can follow almost anything inside of the production within Shotgun, whether it's an entity such as a note, a shot, a version, maybe a publish. You can even follow people that you're working with. And to follow something is very easy, and there's multiple ways of achieving this inside of Shotgun. First, we're looking at the overview page that an artist is logged into for this project. If someone is assigned to a task, such as an artist, they will automatically be set up to be following that task. There's nothing they need to do. It is an automatic process. But very often you'll want to be following something else because maybe you're an artist and someone is doing some other work they're tasked on, and your work is dependent upon the progress of what they're doing. Or maybe you're a manager and you want to follow everything that a specific artist is doing or all the elements of a shot as it's progressing along. A very common way of finding an entity that you want to follow is by using the global search field in the upper right corner. If I enter the name of a specific shot and number, you're going to see the results are going to show me all the different shots relevant with that number and name. I can click on any one of the shots, and it'll take me to the activity page for that specific shot. In the upper right corner, you'll see a button that reads Follow. By clicking on it, this artist is now following this shot. You'll see the icon or button changes to blue and it now reads following. Also along the lower part of the UI, you'll see the icons of all the different people who are followers of this specific shot. If you wanted to unfollow something, you bring your cursor back over the button that reads following and you'll see that it highlights in red and indicates by clicking on it you're going to unfollow this. Let's say the artist wants to follow an asset. They can jump to the asset page, and now along the left-hand side, we see a list of all the different assets that are part of this project. Clicking on one of them brings up that asset page. And then once again, there's the follow button available to you right here. Or you can right-click over any entity or thumbnail, whether it's the assets, shots, tasks, and so on. You'll get the option to follow selected or unfollow selected from the contextual menu. If the artist chooses following from the menu, you'll see once again the following button is highlighted in blue. This is a great workflow when you want to quickly select multiple assets or entities and set to be following all of them. So for example, this artist comes over to the left-hand side, they select multiple assets, right-click, and from the contextual menu, choose Follow Selected. Now this artist is following each one of these assets. But you can also follow just specific tasks of a shot. For example, you can go to the task page, and then from the task name column, you can click on the individual task. You're brought to the activity page for just this specific task. And in the upper right corner, there's our following button. You can easily enable it, and now this artist is following the progress of the rigging task for this asset. If we go back to the overview page for this project, and once again, we'll use the global search field. This time we'll enter a word that is being shared as part of the name of many different shots or different entities. I'll type the word bunny, and I'll click the return or the enter key. Here I'm taken to the global search page, and along the left-hand side, you can see the little blue icon with the letter F in it, indicating what shots this artist is following. If you bring your cursor over the icon or the button that reads F, you'll see it turns to red. This artist can easily unfollow a specific entity. Or bringing the cursor back over any one of these shots or entities, you'll see the follow button reappears. Clicking on it will enable, again, this shot to be followed by this artist. As I mentioned earlier, you can follow people. If I go to the people page, you'll see a list of all the people working on this project. For example, I want to follow everything Daryl is doing. If I right-click over his icon, I have the follow selected and unfollow selected. And just like all the other entities we've looked at and the thumbnails, if I double-click on Daryl's thumbnail, I am taken to Daryl's personal info page. And there is a follow button that allows me to enable the following option or disable following if I'm following someone. Lastly, if a person goes to the upper right corner and clicks on their personal settings, they can go to the account settings. On the account setting page, they can go to the My Following settings where you can refine and control exactly what activities will show up for each one of the entities that you are following. So for example, this artist might not want to be updated and notified in their inbox about versions and published files of the assets, but they do want to receive information about the notes and the tasks. And then below assets, you also have your shots and your tasks where you can refine exactly what activities associated with these individual entities you will receive notifications in your inbox. Then as the production is progressing, you will be receiving only the information you need, the notifications you want in your inbox relevant to the different entities you are following. And even in your inbox, when you select a message, you have the ability to follow and unfollow a specific entity that you are currently following. So that's our tip for today and our 30 tips in 30 days.